Well, we spoke a little bit about Glorious Goodwood at the top of the show, and it was a week that threw up so many brilliant stories. There was a lot of emotion, a lot of very, very happy people, and none more so than trainer David Minutier after the victory of the wonderful filly Wonderful Tonight. And David joins us on the line now. And many thanks for speaking to us, David. How are you feeling after last week? Are you still on cloud nine?
Yeah, no, we are, and feeling quite exhausted actually. We've we, a lot of things to think about, obviously, you know, because we think of Wonderful Tonight, but I mean, we also won with Migration, the first race of the first day of the meeting, and a few others that didn't really run as good as expected. So yeah, it was a lot of pressure, and so today we do feel a bit exhausted still.
Yeah, I can imagine there was quite a lot of pressure, particularly with Wonderful Tonight, because you've had to be quite patient with her, haven't you? Because you've wanted to make sure that she gets her ground conditions, and then we really do see the best of her. I thought she was brilliant last week.
Yeah, I thought she was brilliant, and you know, these sort of races are always hard to assess because obviously you're running against lesser opposition, you know, without being rude. And it's a funny feeling, and it's also our local track, so you don't want to let your friends down.
And we saw some great emotions from your team. And I imagine this filly just means so much to everyone in the stables, doesn't she?
Yeah, of course. I mean, look, not just the stable, you know, I think she's becoming one of the best horses in the UK. So, you know, you can only be proud of a horse like her.
Yeah, absolutely. I love her sort of exuberance. She just seems so happy to be out there doing her job. And what's the plan next for her? Where do we see her next on the step to the arc or the road to the arc?
But look, the next possible options are, you know, the Yorkshire Oaks, possibly at York, and or the Pomone or the Romanée in Deauville, you know, so one of a mile two, one of a mile four and a bit. So that's where she's likely to go. Otherwise, she may go. But after that, she may go to Longchamp for the Vermeil or the Prix Foy. You know, I wouldn't write off running in the Foy because usually there's only a handful of runners. And who knows? It could be an easier race than the fillies race this year.
Yeah, it could. So plenty of options for her. And at the moment, are there any difficulties with travelling horses to France? I imagine it's not quite as simple as it was in say, 2019.
No, it's not as simple as it was. But I mean, we haven't tried yet. You know, I might have my first one in France in about 10 days' time. So, you know, I think the transporters are pretty up to date on what we need to do now to travel. And it takes a bit more time to organize with paperwork and red tape and what have you. But look, there's nothing that we can't do, especially for a filly like her.
Oh, she's fantastic. And away from her, I think you're at 17 winners now for the season. You're on course to have your best ever year, aren't you?
Yeah, look, I don't look at statistics too much, but it feels like we're having our best season. So that's great. Look, I mean, there's still, you know, we're only just at the start of August, so there's plenty more to come. Look, I've got plenty of 2-year-olds. I've got about 40 2-year-olds in training, and I've only run once so far. So, yeah, I'd like to think that, you know, we could end up the season really well.
And what was it that made you set up training in England in the first place, David? Why did you make England your home?
But the main reason is the fact that I was working for John Dunlop, you know, and I spent the last 6 years of Castle Stables there, you know, until John Dunlop retired. So having been there for 6 years, I couldn't see the point of going back to France, you know. And I was in California before that, so I had left France a long time ago. Well, a long time ago, yeah. So there was no much point going back to France. Basically, I thought if I make it as a trainer, it's more likely to be in England than in France. And also, it's very hard to find new clients in France when you first start. So I felt, you know, if we do well in England, we are more likely to have good clients, you know, to back us up, which is what happened.
Well, you've certainly made it, I would say. And how's your involvement been so far with the Racing League? How did you and your team find the experience there last week?
it's pleasant enough. I think, like any new venture, there's you know, a few things to sort out. You know, you can't think of everything, you know, when you create something from scratch. So I think it's a concept that will just get better and better over the next few years. But so far so good. I think we've had a. But our team had a pretty good start last week, and hopefully we can start having a few winners now.
Well, we'll let you go, but it's been fantastic to speak to you, and we'll really enjoy watching Wonderful tonight, wherever she goes next. And best of luck to you and your team for the rest of the season.
Yes, thanks a million for the call, and fingers crossed for the rest of the season.